Previously on the Canadian Rally Championship. After an exciting start to the 2016 season, with the first four events won by four different drivers, reigning champion Antoine Lesage got his season back on track with his second victory of the season. The 22 points brought him back into second place, just 1 point behind Subaru privateer Maxime Labrie, who's held the championship lead since the season began. Now, with two events remaining, it's a battle royale. This weekend is the treacherous and challenging single-day rally of the Tall Pines. This rally hasn't always been kind to Lesage, and before the event begins, adversity builds. On this year's entry list, Subaru Rally Team USA superstar Travis Pastrana is set to compete in what is widely touted as the fastest Subaru rally car in the world. Will the American team cross the 49th parallel and steal the show? Can the defending Canadian champion take the lead of the championship like he's done so many times before? Or will the privateer's consistency hold off the two factory efforts? It's time to find out. Rally of the Tall Pines in Bancroft, Ontario is legendary for its challenging roads and for being a marathon day behind the wheel.
Oh man, definitely, it's a really long day. I'm really looking forward to just getting back racing against Antoine and the rest of the guys up here. It's gonna be a lot of fun, it's gonna be a good battle.
With just a 1 point spread for the lead of the championship and a battle between North and South, a long day of exciting rallying is guaranteed.
The championship in Canada is far from over, and that's the main goal for us, to try to take the lead in the championship and have a good event. Travis and Subaru USA are not here with the same goal. They have no pressure. They can go all out. You know, it's not the case for us. It's also a bit of a lottery, this rally, and hopefully we're in the rhythm and we can have a good battle, but we still have to think of the big picture.
You know, the conditions will be very tricky, so I think a lot of unknown to make it to the end.
Well, we'll see what weather throws at us. At this point in time, we are very confident we're going to keep doing what we've been doing last three, four rallies and push forward. The goal is to win the event and set up a point lead in the championship.
It'll be tough. I think everyone's a little worried about sliding around, but it's going to be slippery roads today, new car, so just going to go out and have fun and hopefully things start to feel good.
Thirty teams will face 190 competitive kilometers over 17 special stages, all in a single day. With the temperature hovering right around freezing, the road conditions are fluctuating hourly. The Canadian Rally Championship is presented by Subaru. Confidence in motion. Without delay, it's off to the woods to start contesting stages. Subaru Canada's Antoine Lesage and Darren Garrett are first on the road.
Okay, you're good?
Yeah. Good luck, Antoine. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Lesage took a major step toward turning this championship around at the Pacific Forest Rally, and now only trails the leader, Maxime Labrie, by 1 point. Antoine has more experience at this rally than most, but this event plays no favorites. Over the last 10 years, he's won this event 4 times, but he's also had 3 DNFs. He'll need to be on his toes today.
3, 2, 1, go. Crest 20, right 3, minus 80.
Although eager to do battle with their Canadian counterparts, this is a development event for Subaru Rally Team USA. Travis Pastrana and Robbie Durant are improving their pace notes in preparation for a full rally season in 2017, which starts at Rally Personnage in January. Seat time and practice is the goal this weekend.
Right 6 minus over max crest, 70.
In droite 6, on crash 80 en descente.
Maxime Labrie's only goal this weekend is to defend his championship lead, but it's a tall order. Lestage is a formidable threat, but a spot on the podium will force a showdown at the final round in British Columbia. Although not able to match the top speed of the factory teams, Labrie sets a good pace from the start. Boris Georgievic has had his best career results this season and is in the championship hunt as well. But a driveline failure will end his rally after just two stages. Brandon Semenuk and John Hall fought their way through attrition to bag a second place finish here in 2015, but the team is shaking down a brand new Subaru Crosstrek today, and it's a steep learning curve.
Right five, a minus over small crest, opens over big crest.
Dave Nickel and Chris Kramer are in a similar Crosstrek, but have a few events under their belt. They've had teething issues thus far, and are off the pace in the first loop of stages today. 2013 Tall Pines winner Chris Martin is off to a flying start. He's opened up a small lead over Maxime Labrie for third. This privateer battle will be one to watch today. In his rookie season, Simon Vincent has already won the novice championship, but he co-drove his father Sylvain to the win here last year, so he's got big shoes to fill. Jason Bailey has made the trip across the country in the hopes of locking up the two-wheel drive championship today, and he's off to a good start, leading the class. But Ian Criere's classic Porsche is the fan favorite so far. Up front, Pastrana lost almost 24 seconds to Lestage on the first stage, but the Nitro Circus star refuses to let that stand. He pulls 7 seconds back on stage two.
And Max Jump, repeat five plus, crest and Max Jump, 70 left, five over the crest.
Dialing up the speed on stage three, Subaru Rally Team Canada pulls another 12 seconds on the Americans.
Into right, four plus over crest opens. Repeat right, four plus over crest opens. Into flat crest, left bank minus long.
Although both Lestage and Pastrana have very different missions, the battle is clearly on. After three stages, Lestage has a 28-second lead on Pastrana. Martin, Labrie, Lamar, and Vanderpool round out the top six. A full day of racing has barely begun at the Rally of the Tall Pines. More after the break.
Subaru has been in Canada for a long time, building a reputation as champions in the toughest of conditions. 11-time Canadian Rally Manufacturers Champion and counting. Claim your own piece of history for $29,995. Subaru, confidence in motion.
We're back at the Rally of the Tall Pines. The teams arrive at the first service of the day with the battle already heated after only three stages, but the conditions have the teams wary.
First stage went really well. I had a good rhythm, but didn't take any chances, but the time was really good. But again, we need to stay focused on why we're here, so I'm not gonna do anything silly. There's a lot of fans here always. Tall Pines is always a very good event for that, and the next few stages will go through the spectator point, so. That's always nice to see a lot of people, but we have to focus on the road.
Antoine was going like a bat out of hell that first stage, so definitely good to see. I feel like we went with ice tires to kind of see. I don't think they were disadvantaged at all in the first two. On the last stage, it started digging down after everyone had been over it. It's the first notes we made in a while, so even though we were hesitant on the first one, I feel like the notes so far have been pretty good. I'm happy with how they were ridden out.
This morning, it's okay, you know, we're still finding our bearings, but we're getting there. It's very nice here, the spectator stages, you know, the Hiron Bridge and the old Detler are very nice, either northbound or southbound with all those spectators. It's very fun.
Things went good. That last stage was pretty hairy, I'll tell you that, but yeah, we're in a good spot.
Back on the stages, Antoine Lestage and Darren Garrett are trying to balance their desire to fight for stage wins with the need to reach the finish. They can't afford to take big risks. The championship chase will go down to the final event of the season, and they want to take home maximum points here.
Crest, don't cut, and care, slippy left, Titans 4 over crest.
It's a simple balancing act for Pastrana and Durant, but they're not letting Lestage off the hook yet. Pastrana takes another 4 seconds out of Lestage on stage 4, but Lestage replies in kind on stage 5.
And right 5 short, 35.
He's coming!
The two factory teams are opening up a gap over third, but the battle for the remaining podium spot is just as heated.
Mid-crest, 80, danger break, kink left and kink left.
Labrie and Martin are trading stage wins for the spot. This matchup will end up coming down to skill, bravery, and the great equalizer, luck. One thing is certain, the big winners here this weekend are the spectators. Season-long contender Dave Nickel is still learning how to get the most from his new cross trek, but he's on a march, moving up 2 places to 8th. The rookie sensation Simon Vincent is up to 7th, but is still learning where and when to push. He narrowly avoids disaster and holds on to his position. Early in the season, Wim van der Poel and Brian Lord established themselves as models of consistency, and it had them in the championship hunt. But bad luck has cost them valuable points, and their struggles continue today. Brandon Semenuk is pushing his new car hard, and it shows. A brush with a tree costs them valuable time, but then their luck goes from bad to worse. Jason Bailey and Shane Peterson have pedaled their Fiesta R2 hard in the two-wheel drive class, and they've built a lead of almost 4 minutes over their nearest competitor. Another loop complete, but the rally isn't even half over. The gap from Lestage to Pastrana stays consistent, while Labrie overtakes Martin in the battle for third. Tino Fortunato holds down 5th, and the production class lead, Semenuk, manages to hold off Vincent despite a shattered windshield. The midday service and more stages are coming up at the Rally of the Tall Pines.
Take your driving to the next level at Dirtfish. Gain confidence behind the wheel of an all-wheel drive Subaru STI or rear-wheel drive Subaru BRZ. Get sideways with skills on multiple surfaces. Gravel, mud, and tarmac. Dirtfish offers programs for every driver. Visit dirtfish.com for details.
In Bancroft, Ontario, at the Rally of the Tall Pines, teams have returned for the midday service. At the top of the running order, the race is on and the drivers are loving it.
Yeah, great loop. It was a lot of fun and I really enjoyed the battle with Travis. The difference between now and when we left the last service is probably the same. I think we took a few seconds, he took a few seconds, we took a few seconds, he took a few seconds, so quite happy so far.
Oh, having a blast and really learned a lot on what we need in our notes for the future. And with Antoine, just to he's such an awesome guy, and it's funny looking at his lines, you know, because we're second on the road. For a guy with a championship on the line, he's definitely, he's giving her, and that makes me feel good as a driver. That's like, all right, we know he's giving it everything, and do everything we can to catch up.
Yeah, you know, I think we had the right tires for the conditions, but it was good fun. You know, the warm-up is done now, so now we're getting into the real rallies. So, yeah, it's going to be a long day still.
Just to finish will be a good thing for me. It's super challenging. The roads are incredibly tough to read. It's a challenge, and I look forward to the night stages where I think it's my strong point, and I'll try to be able to grab some position during the night.
It's rough, it's dirty, it's there's huge ruts, and those guys in those four-wheel drive turbo cars are tearing up all the rocks everywhere, and then we have to go over them with these tiny little tires, and it's tough out there. But we know it's the last leg of the day. It's Egan Creek and those stages that'll really get you. So we need to make it there, and then we need to make it through clean. So there's a lot of racing left to do.
The next loop of stages is critical. Soon, the sun will set, the temperature will drop, and the darkness will add to the challenge. Veteran champions like Antoine Lestage know that this is where the rally is won or lost. But he's done away with any pretense of playing it safe. He wants to win against his American counterparts, and the increasing pace is rapidly opening the gap to third.
Yeah, right, 4+.
Travis Pastrana and Robbie Durant are also driving like they've got something to prove. And although Lestage's experience gives the Canadian an advantage, Pastrana will only concede a handful of seconds over the next two stages. In the battle for third, Chris Martin is starting to lose ground to Maxime Labrie. While it's only a matter of a few seconds per stage, it's enough to build a buffer for when darkness falls. This season has seen Labrie get better and better at this kind of strategic driving. He's always been fast, but now he's thinking of the bigger picture, and it shows in his success thus far. Dave Nicol is finding a rhythm in his cross trek. But he can't seem to get ahead of Simon Vincent, who is now up to fifth. Back from a crash at the Pacific Forest Rally, Tino Fortunato is leading the production all-wheel drive class in sixth overall. The sun sets, and with the darkness comes a change in fortune. Though he doesn't know it yet, Antoine Lestage is losing the rear brakes on his car, causing unpredictable handling, especially troublesome as the road conditions worsen.
Right, 5 and finish, long, opens late over crest, 50. You okay?
Yeah, something's wrong in the back.
This should open the door for Subaru Rally Team USA to take the lead, but Travis Pastrana has his own problems. Deep in the longest stage of the event, the right rear wheel gets torn from the car, forcing him to limp through the remaining mileage before service.
Well, I don't even know if we hit anything.
I think it's just the way it is.
The damage to Pastrana's car costs him almost 2 minutes to Lestage. Labrie manages to stay ahead of Martin. With four stages remaining, the teams have their work cut out for them at the final service.
We're losing the rear brakes, so it was very hard in the long stage, and it's insane. You guys have no idea how it is out there. Typical tall pine, it's not over until it's over.
It's not that I underestimated Antoine. I knew he'd be coming out swinging. We still had half the rally to go, so kind of started turning it up. Had probably the stage of my life. We were probably backwards more than forwards, so maybe not the smoothest stage, but he beat us by, I think, 6 seconds in there. But he's got to survive the conditions to make it. Everyone does to make it back. It's icy, it's snowy, there's some gravel, there's some mud, and there are rocks the size of Volkswagens in that long 29-kilometer stage. So it's going to be survival from here on out.
The final grueling loop of stages at Rally of the Tall Pines when we come back.
Subaru has been in Canada for a long time, building a reputation as champions in the toughest of conditions. 11-time Canadian Rally Manufacturers Champion and counting. Claim your own piece of history for $29,995. Subaru, confidence in motion.
This is it, the final four stages at Rally of the Tall Pines, and the teams are in survival mode. The Canadian Rally Championship is presented by Subaru. Confidence in motion.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
These are the moments when Antoine Lestage and Darren Garrard shine. They've taken command of this rally and will now seek out the perfect balance between maintaining the lead and keeping the car out of the ditches. Other drivers might get caught up in the excitement of leading or play it too safe and bleed time, but not Lestage. Travis Pastrana and Robbie Durant are smart enough to know that challenging for the win with a 2-minute deficit and four treacherous night stages ahead would be foolish. They've returned to their original mission of developing their pace notes, but they're still setting a pace others can't match.
Repeat right, three Titans minus, left three, opens, long.
Having led the class for most of the day, Jason Bailey perseveres through the night to win the rally and take a commanding lead in the two-wheel drive championship. As predicted, the night brings a shakeup to the leaderboard. Chris Martin suffers a wheel bearing failure, seemingly handing the podium to Labrie. But the championship leader suffers his own misfortunes, forcing him to pull over for repairs.
Okay, la roue vient de casser.
Je détache, je détache.
A heartbreaking turn of events. The attrition continues as Dave Nickel is also having mechanical issues, allowing Simon Vincent to catch and pass him on the stage. The rookie is on fire through the night stages, moving up through the order rapidly. He also squeezes past the stricken Labrie, moving up to third. Bad luck for Labrie, but an incredible performance from Vincent.
Oh, 30? What side over smooth crest?
With only 9 national cars still running, Antoine Lestage and Darren Garrard lead them to the end of the final stage. Lestage has demonstrated yet again why he's the most successful driver in Canadian rally history, riding the fine line between risk and conservation perfectly to the finish line.
Okay, well done, Antoine. Bloody hell.
That's a good one.
Yeah, job well done. That's tough.
Yes.
Oh, what a tough rally.
Lestage wins in commanding fashion, with Pastrana and Vincent rounding out the podium. Fortunato, Nickel, and Vanderpool round out the top 6. With Labrie's DNF, Lestage jumps ahead of him in the championship, with Georgievic rounding out the top 3.
Very, very nice victory and great day from start to finish, and no major problems. So thanks to Subaru Canada, to Rocket Rally, and Darren, who did a great job on the notes. That was the main goal, to try to come out of here leading the championship. So we needed a strong result and try to finish ahead of our main competition. And on top of that, there was Travis. So I was always in between, you know, thinking of the championship and fighting with him. And at the end, it's just perfect. So we're taking the lead in the championship. Plus, we've won the battle with Travis. So quite happy.
And I tell you what, Antoine's been such a good friend and a good opponent for a long time, but it's been so long since I got to race him. So I really thought we'd start making some ground, and he just kept on trucking, man. So it was awesome making some notes. Got a lot more comfortable with Robbie. We know a lot of what we're going to need to do for Pierre Stage to get those notes a little bit better from my perspective. But it was an awesome day. Up in the air more than on the ground, backwards more than forwards, but pretty cool.
It was a tough fight out there. The roads were incredibly rough. We had 4 flats today, and we had lots of challenges today, but we got to the end, and that's what really mattered, and yeah, I feel good.
Am I dreaming or what? Oh, somebody got to pinch me, right? So
I was not expecting that. You know, not many like co-drivers and driver can say, last year I did a podium and this as a co-driver, and this year I'm doing it as a driver. I don't know what to say, I'm just speechless, you know? Made it through the end. All the people are like, hey, you're unofficial third, but you're third. I'm speechless, really. I be aside of those guys. Wow.
All right, first place overall goes to Antoine Lestage and Darren Garrard. Congratulations, guys!
The penultimate chapter of the 2016 Canadian Rally Championship is complete, and with the title chase going down to the final event of the season, the Big White Winter Rally promises to be an exciting end to the saga.